using the saw. Initially, I like a saw, but then you can go back over the lines or the surface you've cut and use the edge of the saw blade, but more like a file. Imagine the blade, a very narrow needle file. Actually, far more delicate. But much easier to do this kind of work with a saw than with a needle file. Because with a saw, you're pushing it. I mean, with a file, you're pushing it. And it's a very short stroke, really. And the needle files, of course, change. They taper, don't they? Whereas a saw frame, you've got quite a long travel if you want it, and it doesn't taper, and you can really see what you're doing, because the file is in front of what you're doing. So you can't really see. You can only see after you've filed, whereas with a saw frame, with a blade, you can actually see what's happening. You're literally paring it away. Almost like with a scalpel. And if you've got a nice flat surface you're coming off, that principle that I always allude to, coming off of a datum line, the flat of the blade is supported on the cut surface. But you can pivot off that. There's quite a lot of control. That's the kind of technique that used to be used for opening up the mountings for diamonds in pave setting. You'd even do the front, the conical seating for the diamonds with the saw frame. And the back, of course, it can be cut open to provide opening for light to get in, supposedly. And they would carve with the blade either square or a rope-like pattern. There's no end of what you can do with a saw blade when you start to use it more like a very fine file.